Welcome back. To Forspoken, Tanta We Trust.
What do we have here? Is this
interesting?
Do you mind if I asked you a few questions?
Please. I only hope I can tell you what you wish to know.
So, just to be clear, these markings mean I'm some kind of Reddick weapon, right? And I'm stuck this way. Just boom, no more Talia.
It pains me to say it, but yes. You may recall Aldacor mentioning the gloaming. It is a ceremony conducted at sunset, at its completion. Or if you die before it's completed, you will explode.
Fuck. Okay, do you know why the mark spread to my other arm?
I do not. But your powers have grown as it has. Could this indicate a more devastating result when the inevitable finally occurs?
Whoa, okay, hang on. If I explode, I kill everyone around me, right? Wouldn't that include the Reddick themselves?
It would. And yet seemingly they wish it, nonetheless. I cannot pretend to understand their motives.
Jeez, what do they put in the water over there?
Why does it not surprise me that the concept of commitment is utterly alien to you?
What exactly is Aldacor trying to achieve?
By bringing about the gloaming. I do not know. But I worry we are perilously close to finding out.
What even is the gloaming? It can't just be about blowing me up.
No, I fear it cannot. There must be more to it than simply that.
Why do I get the feeling I don't want to find out? How did you know to come and find me?
The Reddick have attempted to perform the gloaming once before. We managed to stop them, but only just.
So, I'm not the first person they've done this to?
No. There was another. And she too, I was forced to eliminate. When Ola sensed that another vessel had been created, I knew that I must do my duty once again.
And by duty, you mean killing me, right? So, are these marks on my arms the reason I can use magic?
I believe so. At least I cannot think what else might explain your newfound powers.
So, why do you think destroying the tree's roots made me stronger?
I can only speculate. There was no tree, and no crystals the last time the ceremony was performed. Are you ready?
Could you, tell me a little about yourself?
What could you possibly wish to know?
Well, I don't have much time left. Thought I'd try and get to know you while I can.
Very well. What would you like to know?
I don't know. Let's see, did you, ever maybe want to start a family?
A Tanta is not permitted to bear children. Surely you know this.
Yeah, of course, but if you take off your Tanta hat for just a second.
Well, were I not a Tanta, I imagine having a family might be a rather wonderful thing. But I am a Tanta, therefore such considerations are irrelevant.
But you're the Tanta of love, aren't you? Don't you think experiencing a mother's love for her child might maybe add some perspective?
That would be a betrayal of my duty to Athia.
Okay, I get it. I just never had a mom, and I don't know, you seem like you'd be a good one to have.
That's an unusual compliment.
Well, that's all I got, so Let's go kick Aldecor's ass and take back Vesoria.
Talia, you do realize how this ends. I will have no choice but to...
Kill me. I know. But, well, Athia is my home too. So you do what you gotta do to keep it safe. Now let's go.
Talia, the Reddick will be expecting us.
Let me guess. Don't be too hasty, don't rush in, right?
Not at all. I trust you will do the right thing. I merely wish to say that my strength is yours, should you require it.
Is it just me, or has she softened up a little?
I cannot tell you how little your blossoming bond interests me.
Really take care. Why this tree was so important.
As do I. It must play an important role in their ceremony.
Shit!
Talia!
Not sure I like being this popular.
They are no match for us if we work together. Tell me, if you please.
Okay. Damn.
Returning the favor.
Take that.
Tanta, let's end this! There it is! You're toast! Heads up! This ought to be good.
Of a nobody from yesteryear.
I'm touched by your concern. Surprised.
Out of our way. We will kill you if we must.
Yep. Huh. What if this was what the Force wanted all along? Maybe this is what we learned what we're supposed to do about the break.
Right on the money.
suspect the Reddick will have more surprises in store.
It'll take a lot of surprises to stop us.
I believe it would.
Best not to overthink these things, eh? That's a rather poetic turn of phrase, don't you think?
Sure, if you're in a batshit fanaticism. Hey, Cuff. You know, I really think Talia and I would have gotten along.
And why is that, pray tell?
She was willing to put everything on the line for the people she cared about, just like me and Cinta.
And you know this how, exactly? Your famous Tanta instinct, perhaps?
No, it's... I just can feel it. I know this is what she would have wanted. So you know nothing about this ceremony you keep hearing about?
Not a sausage, sorry. But I imagine it's suitably poignant and dramatic.
And this theory is based on what exactly?
Oh, I don't know. Call it a sort of patriotic instinct.
All right. I am fully rested and fighting fit.
I'll take that to mean you're ready to leave.
Look out! Shit! Better try to not get fried!
be all of them. Now for Aldecor.
Why do I feel we are being led by our noses?
What do you mean?
Nothing. Come. This way. Ah!
Okay, this is one tall tree. Do not go down.
But please, do watch where you step. Always useful.
You got that right.
Finally. I was worried you might have a change of heart.
The gloaming, what does it do?
It destroys Athia, of course. With the help of a vessel, that's you. And a flourishing tree of offering, like the one you see before you.
What the hell does that mean?
My, has it flourished. Thanks to you. You wouldn't believe the amount of life force this takes. I had feared, despite my best efforts to secure a healthy supply, that there simply wouldn't be enough. But then you two came along. And you started killing all my soldiers. And voila. Death begets life.
Are you saying we helped you?
And in more ways than one. You were a perfectly adequate vessel before, but thanks to the power you've absorbed, the gloaming will now leave Athia with deeper wounds than we ever dreamed of. All we need do is await the inevitable. For when the core shines its brightest, the gloaming will come to pass.
I'm afraid we cannot allow that. Your wretched ceremony will fail as well.
Then I will show you what we ready are truly capable of.
Let him get you!
How'd you like this? Wait, shield again, but now we know how to break it! That's not doing much. Aha! You're gonna love this!
for the gloaming failed, did it not? Tali, forgive me. I thought I could save you. It's okay. Listen to me. Listen. Something bad was gonna happen. I don't know when. Soon. Dahlia, it's all right. You don't have to. When it does, promise me you won't lose hope.
Am I
back in your own time?
Did Talia die?
Yes. Her final moments were the beginning of the end. You saw the bird. Thus was the Cerus called forth.
What does that mean? Did Talia become the Cerus?
No. As Aldacor said, she was merely a vessel. And though Cinta tried her hardest, she was not able to prevent his return. His power grew in the years that followed, until Athia faced total destruction at his hand.
Staric stuff. I'd shed a tear if I were able.
But where did Cerus even come from? Aldacor couldn't have made him.
Indeed, no mortal could have created such an abomination. Cerus owes his existence to a far more terrifying power.
A more terrifying power?
Interesting.
I don't even know who I'm talking to. Who are you?
I am one of the Tantas of Red Earth.
Say what?
The answers you seek lie beyond Athia's borders. Come to me. I will be waiting.
Wait, no, wait, just hold on. Can you just... Great. Well, Cuff, I hope you're ready for a trip to Retta.
Home, sweet home. I'm sure the horrors awaiting us won't be too life-threatening. Did I mention how marvelous it was to witness my illustrious rebirth? What a privilege for us both.
Not listening.
I wasn't expecting to get through it that fast. I was expecting like 6 to 8 hours, and this was like 3. That's fine. I don't know what's next. I'll figure something out. But until then, we will catch you next time.